welcome back, beloved. Today we're going to be talking about this. The Jewish people are praying for the Antichrist. And I'm going to be playing a pretty amazing video I saw back from February 2021. So basically just 7 months ago or so. And so the Jewish people in Israel and throughout the world actually had a massive event hosted by a couple other religious, you know, parties got involved. Obviously all Jewish people, and they were praying for the Messiah. They were praying for their Jewish Messiah that they're waiting for. And Jesus even said in John chapter 5, I've come in my Father's name, in the name of God, and you do not receive me. If another comes in his own name, him you will receive. And I've been excited to make this video. I'm going to try and make it pretty quick for a while now, but I think now is a really good time to do it. And so here's the prayer. Basically, the entire event is centered around this huge prayer. And so here's the prayer. Master of the universe, we, the children of Israel, all united around the world at this moment, are crying out to you. Please accept our prayer with grace and kindness. We sincerely thank you for all your daily blessings. But we also thank you for sending Moshiach, that's the word for Messiah, to redeem us. Now and with mercy, from this too long exile and all sufferings, and to bring peace in the world, to bring peace in the world. So the goal of the Messiah is to bring peace in the world that they are praying for. We cannot wait anymore. We also desire your great and one name to be revealed and your presence back to the rebuilt Holy Temple. So, couple key things. One, peace. Remember, I'm going to bring up a verse in a second. I talk about that a lot. They are praying for the Messiah, that he would bring peace to the world, and they are praying for a holy temple. And so this event, this is the community of Beatitudes. This is part of the Catholic Church claiming to be Christians. This event, it was, you know, kind of hyped up a lot. The Jewish organization is called All Jews as One, and it was a prayer event. And this is the Catholic Church. I just wanted to tie in these two that say there's basically six essential points that unite Christians and Jews. One is faith in one God. You see, that sounds nice. Like, wow, we both believe in one God. We're united. But it's not reality. You see, we believe Jesus is the Messiah. He is God in human flesh. So we're not united with people who reject the true Messiah. Jesus is coming back to bring peace on this earth. However, he already came 2,000 years ago so that we could have an eternal peace between us and God, right? He died for our sins. But the Catholic Church says that they actually also share the hope in the coming of the Messiah and prayer for peace in the world. And this is what happens when a church falls away from the truth. Unfortunately, most of them probably are not walking in a relationship with God through Christ. And so you can just put out some of these strange doctrines and nobody will even question it. It's kind of insane to say that a Christian and a Jew have this in common, faith in one God, but also hope in a coming Messiah. Jesus said specifically, don't look for me. Now, we look for Jesus in the sense that we can't wait for him to come back, but he said, don't look for me as a person, here on this earth. When I come back, as lightning flashes from the east to the west, I mean, it's going to be huge with cataclysmic judgments. It's not like we're waiting for a person to show up on the scene again. He already did, okay? And so very important. So just to reiterate, remember, they're praying for peace, they're praying for the Messiah and the Holy Temple. And so here are two verses that are amazing. 1 Thessalonians 5 says, when they say peace and safety, it's talking about the day of the Lord, then sudden destruction comes upon them. I bring up this verse a lot as the whole world is looking for peace. Many religious groups are sort of uniting around this push for peace. But the Bible's very clear, there is no peace for the wicked. Now, we don't want war or anger or hostility, but this whole world peace thing, it's a Trojan horse. It's not dealing in biblical reality. And so 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, this is really key. It's talking about the Antichrist. It says, he opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God or that is worship, so that he sits as God in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. So the Jewish people are praying for peace. There's one warning sign. They're praying for a Messiah, but he already came. So they're actually praying for the Antichrist. And they're praying for the Holy Temple, where the Antichrist will proclaim that he is God. And it's really amazing because they have a temple institute. You can Google them. They have so many things prepared for this third temple. So now I'm going to bring up this video, and then I'll just close with a couple verses.
Breaking news. A historical world event is happening just before Purim on Sunday, February 21st. At the exact same moment, all around the globe, an emotional, heartfelt call will arise from all Jews to heaven for Mashiach to reveal himself. Observant, non-observant, Ashkenazi, Sephardic, Hasidim, all Jews as one. Even you famous Jews, let's be the actors, witnesses of this better world that we so much hope for.
Ron du Mossad pour l'opération Necher.
Ils ont mis Bounik sur le coup.
Coupé.
Mais quoi? Qu'est-ce qui va pas?
Rien, mais ça y est, il est 17h.
Ah oui, ok, on se met à fond sur la prière pour Mashiach là.
Ribono shel olam, nous les béné Israël, tous unis dans le monde entier en ce jour, nous crions vers toi.
On a come on a break?
I'll meet you there. Master of the universe, we the children of Israel, all united around the world at this moment.
Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad.
Are you aware that we have to do the worldwide prayer to demand Mashiach?
Of course I am. I have it on my phone. Let's say it together.
Master of the Universe.
Евреи?
Да.
Я тоже из России.
Через 5 минут все евреи должны прочесть маленькую молитву и попросить Всевышнего прощения.
Мессиях?
Да.
Господин Всевышний, мы народ Израиля.
Bonjour, ici Paris. Montre réglée, nous sommes tous préparés pour cette prière. À vous, Rome.
Grazie, Parigi. Qui in Italia lo stesso, siamo tutti molto fiduciosi nella risposta divina.
מיליונים של אנשים מתפללים את אותה תפילה באותו זמן, אז בוודאי זה דבר שהוא יעשה רעש בשמיים, ויקרב את הגאולה ויביא את המשיח. שהתפילה הזאת תהיה תפילה המועילה, תהיה רצון שכולם יתפללו אותה ויבוא משיח, אמן כן רצון.
Un jour, on écoute la voix d'Hashem, le Mashiach y vient. Ne gâchez pas cette opportunité.
The world is in chaos. The only thing that can really save our planet is Mashiach. The only thing that Mashiach is waiting for are our prayers.
All Jews as one contribute to the sanctification of Hashem's name.
L'idée de tous ensemble prier au même moment va donner à notre prière collective pour la Géoula une force exceptionnelle.
Let's ask the kids what they think about this historic.
And so, I mean, it is pretty amazing. They're saying we need peace. The world is in chaos. The same reason the Jewish people rejected Jesus, the true Messiah, it's the same reason today. They just want peace right now. They want economic prosperity. They want governmental prosperity. They want to be this conquering kingdom, right? And so Jesus said to his disciples, "Ought not the Christ, the Messiah, to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory. And let's look at some Old Testament scriptures about the Messiah just to close up. It's pretty amazing. These are Jewish scriptures. We worship the Jewish Messiah. It's Jesus, right? Isaiah 53, but he was wounded, pierced for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. By his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him, on Jesus, the iniquity of us all. And so they reject that because they just want peace and prosperity. They don't want a sacrifice for their sins because they don't believe they need a sacrifice for their sins. Zechariah 12:10 says, when Christ comes back, when the Lord comes back, it says, I will pour, God will pour on the house of David and on the inhabitants of Jerusalem, the spirit of grace and supplication. Then they will look on me, on God, whom they pierced. Yes, they will mourn for him as one mourns for his only son, and grieve for him as one grieves for a firstborn. There God is saying, the Messiah, they're going to pierce him, and the Messiah is God. Revelation 1:7, after Jesus had died, obviously says, Behold, he is coming with clouds, and every eye will see him, even they who pierced him. And all the tribes of the earth will cry out because of him. Even so, amen. And so you can see it's very, very clear here what's happening. First Peter talks about this. He says, Therefore, to you who believe in Christ, he is precious. But to those who are disobedient, the stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. The builders, the Jewish people, right? They rejected their own cornerstone. Why? Because he is a stone of stumbling and a rock of offense. To accept Jesus, it is the most humble act you can actually do as a human being. It is recognizing your own worthlessness, your own sinfulness, and the worthiness of Jesus, our Messiah. He is the only way out of escaping for the justice and the condemnation, the wrath of God that abides on us, right? So he is a rock of offense. Many people, even some Christians, unfortunately, think they love Jesus, but then when you learn about the Jesus of Scripture, you stumble. It says they stumble being disobedient to the word to which they were also were appointed. And so right now you can see the Jewish people are clearly praying for the Antichrist. They're still rejecting the Messiah, but that time is coming, just like Zechariah. They will look on him whom they pierced. There is going to be a national revival for the Jewish people at the time of the end, and we look forward to that.